Welcome back. So, in our last video, we made a very, very basic pickup, and it had no physics. It just had sort of that pickup mesh to represent it in the world, this very, very artistic cube here, and whether or not the pickup was active or inactive. Now, we're going to make the battery that's really going to be one of the key parts of our gameplay. Eventually, the battery pickup will have physics so it can fall from the sky, it will have a power level, and it will be destroyed after we pick it up. Right now, for this video, we're mostly just going to focus on creating the battery that inherits from the base, and then setting the physics changes, and sort of showing how that works within the project. So, let me just switch back over to the editor real quick, and save while I'm thinking of it. I just noticed that that little asterisk was there, so our blueprint is not saved. Go ahead and save it. And now we will go to C++ classes here in the content browser. And you could actually just right-click here on pickup and create a C++ class derived from it, the same way we made our blueprint before. But I want you to be able to see how to find some of the more complex classes that you may need to use at some point while working on your project. So, we're going to add a new C++ class, again here in the content browser with the Add New button. And we do have this base list of classes like characters, pawns, actors, HUDs, blueprint function libraries, you know, a lot of fairly useful, fairly common things. But if you ever really need to branch out, find any of the classes that you can inherit from, you can use this Show All Classes checkbox. And here you have a list of, you know, just about everything. So in here we can search for pickup, select that, click next, and we will call this class Battery Pickup. Again, if you name it something different, your code will look a little bit different than mine, but you should still be able to follow along. So go ahead and create class. That's going to compile, and then obviously reload the module, and we will get started changing the new battery class functionality. Okay, so our new class got added, the hot reload was complete, and all the little toast popped up and faded away because there were no issues. So let's go check out the code and start adding our battery functionality. Now if you notice, here in Visual Studio, I should really fill out my copyright notice, actually, so that my template gets filled out correctly. But that's easy to do in the project settings. And then we include pickup.h because that's what we inherit from. We've got that generated header file again. And but we don't have nearly as much boilerplate as we did here in the base pickup file. So again, if you need an example to look at, you could just come over here and be like, oh, this is how you override and create your begin play override. So that's kind of what the template code here is nice. But we're going to make our own constructor over here anyway, so that's fine. So we need to make it public. And again, set default values. Actually, let me just mention copying template code. I'm going to go do that really quick. So over here in the pickup, you see here where it says set default values for this actor's properties. We're just gonna take this constructor declaration and copy it over here and then just put in a battery. So a battery pickup. And then we'll go to our source file and put that over here. Again, set default value. And a battery pickup. Doesn't take any arguments. And so when I showed the slide before, I said this pickup is going to fall from the sky. The batteries are going to spawn up in space somewhere and fall down on the character where he can then collect them. So remember we had that get mesh function from before, and that was public. We're going to use that here and say, okay, we've got that mesh and there's all kinds of things we could do. We could add an impulse and like shoot it across the room. We could, there's a lot of, you know, adding forces and impulses. We could change the offset or rotation. You know, all the things you could do with a static mesh component. But what we want to do is set simulate physics to true. And again, we see here an auto complete set simulate physics. Let's just click on that or press enter. There we go. And we'll call set simulate physics to true. That means as soon as the batteries spawn in, they will fall from the sky. And if you remember from the end of the last video, when I moved the pickup box in originally, it just sort of hovered in the air. So obviously physics was not set to simulate on the box. So that really is the only change we're going to make right now. Later we're going to come back and add power and collection, but this is the very basic thing. So let's go back to the editor and compile. And then we'll make a blueprint based on our battery pickup. And again, to set the static mesh property on either the pickup or the battery pickup, we could have hard-coded those references. But if we wanted to, you know, move the meshes around or easily tweak it without having to go back and recompile, that would be trickier. So to create a code class with the variables you know you want to set, and then create a blueprint to set those variables, that's really, you know, the kind of the recommended best practices in a lot of cases. Okay, so that compile looks like it succeeded. And again, we'll right-click here on battery pickup and create a blueprint class based on that. We'll call this battery underscore BP and save it in that blueprints folder I made previously. So go ahead and make that. And again, it's going to open the full blueprint editor. And I could, if I closed and reopened, it would be that data only. But I don't need to do that right now. So you see the pickup mesh here. And we will set the static mesh. And we've got that battery that I copied out of the content examples project. Just scroll down and find that. And it looks like my shaders are compiling, so there we go. And we're ready to try this one out. So let's put the battery in the world just like we did before. And hit play. Huh, so it did fall while the box is still here in the air. And I do know why the battery fell through, so I'm gonna show you guys how to fix that. If for some reason you ever set simulate physics on something and it just plummets to the world like that, let's take a look at sort of the first thing to take a look at. I'm just gonna go back and search because I don't know where that copied that to, but we're gonna go look at our battery mesh. And SM battery medium. And here in the static mesh editor, you can actually look at the collision. And I'm clicking that, and you notice how there's no green line showing up. There's no primitives. And that's why it's falling to the world. There's no box showing where the collision would be, so it can never collide, so it can never stop on the floor, so it's just gonna keep falling forever. So let's fix that really quick. Up here in the top menu, you've got collision, and we're going to use 10.z, which, if you notice, kind of makes a cylinder. Whoops, let me turn down my camera speed a little bit there. Makes a cylinder in the Z direction. So the Z axis is this way, and that's where the cylinder is centered around. If you really wanted to, do you see how there's this little top inset? If you wanted to fit closer around that, we could remove that collision and then use like 18, which kind of goes a little bit closer around it. We can go with that. That way it'll kind of roll around on that top edge a little bit more. So go ahead and save that. And as you can see, that collision shows up when I click on the box or click on that icon there in the toolbar. And now when I hit play, there, it just sits on the floor like that. So I can, you know, come over there and kick it along the ground, things like that. So, and again, here's our base pickup that didn't have set simulate physics to true, and it's just hovering there in the air. So again, just wanted to show a quick how you could make the battery inherit from the pickup, and we're going to add more functionality to the battery in upcoming videos. Thanks.